That's our last podcast for 2017. Oh my gosh.
Can you believe it?
No.
Well, we've only done seven, but.
Is this seven or eight?
I think this is eight. This is a mini one.
This is just a sweet farewell to a beautiful, beautiful year.
Correct.
And we are looking forward to 2018. We just wanted to say thank you for all your viewership, your subscribers, your lovely comments. There are a few thumbs down, but we'll deal. We'll get over it. I'm Diana, by the way.
I'm Pam.
You can find me at The Knitting Place on Ravelry, The Knitting Place on Facebook, The Knitting Place on Instagram.
Pam Sapp on Ravelry and Pam Sapp on Instagram.
You might be hearing the automatic winder in the back. We're like frantically...
It's going.
Hold on, let me turn the machine off.
I have to take this off. I'm too hot right now.
Well, why don't you tell them what it is?
Well, what I just took off is it's one of my Christmas gifts. I will not tell you who it's for, although I doubt that they would even see this, but it's a brioche cowl. How do you like that?
Love it.
It's black and gray. I was given direction that it should be neutral. Of course, we were picking out colors that were a little more vibrant than this. But anyway, this is one of the Christmas gifts that I finished.
Kudos to you.
Yes, I'm knitting.
Sorry, I'm already on vacation mode.
Is that a good
got my
treat?
Jacket on. I'm out
She's
the door.
She's ready to go. And this is another gift I finished. One of our Betty's.
That's beautiful.
Oh, geez, I pulled the pom-pom off, Diana.
Don't worry, it's a snap.
I'm a little aggressive. There you go.
Anger management.
A little too aggressive.
Oh my God.
I think we're anxious to go, right? I can't get it on. Hold on.
What'd you use to knit the Betty?
I used caracole. Caracole from Malabrigo.
It's absolutely
and
gorgeous.
I think the color was rich chocolate, which is a really coppery brown.
I know you made it as a gift.
Yes. Dinah says I need to make one for myself.
I think she needs to keep it for herself.
Look at this. Look at that. Anyway.
It's so gorgeous.
This is another Christmas gift. So there you go.
Two down. How many more to go?
Oh, please. Wait,
where's, you have a scarf.
I do have a scarf that's just about done, really. It'll probably be done tonight. The whole thing with the scarf, it depends how long you want it to be. But it's growing and it's growing and it's growing. But it's really nice. It was the Pearless...
Ribbed scarf
from Pearl Soho. And I used
the... knit stitch, right? All you do is knit.
Yeah, it's knitting and slipping. And all I did was I used the Simply Natural from, Skisel?
Mm-hmm.
It's from Skisel, which is, I think it's
a haiku
wool,
yarn.
Yeah, wool, silk, and alpaca is what it is, I believe. I only know that because I was telling someone yesterday.
It's got a pretty fleck in it.
Yeah,
I don't know if you could see it.
It's fun.
But it's fun.
So we're in vacation mode. This is it.
I actually knit the same scarf for Alice. And today's his birthday.
You did.
And I gifted it to him this morning.
And she took a beautiful picture and put it on Instagram.
Yeah, but let me just talk about that picture. He forgot the scarf at home, which is outrageous.
She was killing herself.
I literally wove in the ends this morning. Like, really.
And then he left without it.
He was leaving without it. And I asked him about the scarf. So needless to say, I had him strike a pose and I took a picture. I blasted it on Instagram and Facebook.
Yeah.
Shared it with the world.
That's what.
And now it's on YouTube. And I will insert a photo.
There you go. Insert a photo.
So I did the same scarf pattern. I used the Jade Sapphire cashmere kit.
Right.
And
it's a great pattern, you know. I find that it looks like the mistake rib, but what I liked about it even more so was it doesn't pull in as much as
correct.
The mistake rib.
I was going to just say that. It does not pull in as much.
It doesn't pull in
as much. It's not so much of an accordion,
You know, and you're not purling, you know, for those of us who might get tired of purling and say, I don't want to purl, although... You know, Dinah said, you even said that you would have gone faster if you were doing the mistake rib.
Yeah, for some reason, I made so many mistakes on what looks like the mistake rib scarf.
Right.
Thank you, Pearl Soho. It was a beautiful pattern.
But it was fun. So we're just finishing up the last things. And, you know, you get to the point where that's it.
Nothing we're done. I finished Danielle's blanket. I should take a picture and show you guys. It's came out beautiful. It was her Hanukkah present.
That was the knit collage.
It was the knit collage Wanderlust, and she loves it, and it's very pretty. So I'll have to insert a picture. I did finish that as well.
Mm-hmm.
What else did I finish? Those are the only two pieces. Jake is going to have to wait.
His blanket's going to take a
little
more
time. It's a big one. Yep.
He's going to take a little. But she's going away. At least she can take it with her when she goes.
I'm not taking. Oh, Danielle?
Danielle.
Yes,
right,
no.
Because
Danielle
is done.
For sure.
He's in New York now. So,
right.
You know,
I could just give it
done,
to him.
It's done, right. So our next big thing, when we come back from vacation.
I can't stand myself. I smell like a latke.
What?
Oh, from guys.
Hanukkah.
Yes.
She's a Hanukkah latke.
Do you smell it on me?
I don't, no.
Really? Oh, my God.
No. Well, you're wearing, well, you weren't wearing this, were you? Were you wearing this that day?
No.
Okay.
I don't think
well,
I was.
Well, you would know. You
maybe
would know.
I was, but this isn't what smells.
I see. I think it's the leather. I think the
it's
leather
like the
of
skin.
Your jacket kind of absorbed the smell, and I think it's going to take longer to get rid of it.
So we were out at my friend's house, and I was in the kitchen while she was making the latkes, and let me just tell you, I reek. And she's actually texting me right now, wondering what time she should be at my house tonight for dinner.
There you go.
So anyway, I'm looking forward to break. How about you? You have some beautiful days.
I am as well. We're going up to Cooperstown, New York.
Yes.
To spend the holidays with the family. Yeah, and Lucy's other side. So it's going to be both families will be with little Lucy this year, and it'll be her first Christmas.
That's so special that you'll all be together.
It will be very nice. And then, you know, there'll be knitting time. And they'll
be taking any knitting with you?
What did we just do, Dan? How many things did I just...
She wound a lot of yarn. A lot.
How much did we just pack up, right? But
I'll pack
in my bag. That's for sure. I should have that. I'll pack in my bag. Right?
Yes.
But...
Do a nice little Instagram story with that one.
Yes, yes, yes.
Well, I'm taking my swancho. Are you going to knit on your swancho?
I should knit on my swancho.
You know, we have to be at the divide by the time we get back.
Is that right?
Yes.
Well, I don't know about that.
So for those of you who are doing our knit along, our mild goal is to have the swancho ready to separate for cuffs.
But don't you think that, I hate to say this, but a lot of the customers are ahead of us.
They are.
You have to admit it. They're ahead of us.
They're definitely ahead of me.
Yeah. I name one that's not. I can't even think of one that's not.
I'm the last. I'm actually.
You're behind me.
Yeah, I don't think anyone is behind design.
Well, but why is that, Diana? Why is that, Diana? Let Diana tell you why she's behind. She did a switcheroo on her colors.
I'm much happier now.
Yeah, so it's all about being happy with what you're knitting, right?
Yep. I'm much
she's
happier.
Happy now.
I tend to do that a lot, don't I? I start and then I give up.
No.
Yeah, I start something and then I want to change
color.
My colors.
Yeah, but that's not giving up. That's not, you just, you know.
I give up on my palette. You know what?
No, because
I try to
you
be
don't
adventurous.
Like it. You don't like it. And if you're knitting it and you're not liking it, what's the sense?
No, I try to be adventurous with my colors. Wow. And then I end up going back to my usual boring palette. But I do
well,
like to
knit
in palette. Color.
The one you gave up on was not, you know, necessarily very adventurous.
Well, it was just a little bright for me.
The pink.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just felt like the pink was a little too bright for what I wanted.
But what did I say to you, Diana? I did say to Diana when she was picking her
she
colors,
said,
I said, but you just did pink. And she said to me, I'm in a pink
mood.
I've been
in a pink mood. I know. I should just, you know.
Then she stopped doing it.
All right, guys, next time I'll listen to Pam.
Well,
for the record.
Yeah,
I'm
you heard that.
You heard
that. We'll see. No, it's but here. I think a lot of times when you pick your colors, you really have to start knitting it. There goes my phone. You really have to start knitting it and see what it looks like to really tell if you're really gonna like what it is. I think.
I mean,
I started mine, and I'm not thrilled with my colors.
Oh, you have such a gorgeous palette. Mm.
You know, it's not neutral enough. I think it should be more neutral.
Are you kidding me?
I think it's too bright. Yeah. Well, that's my feeling. But again, you know, you never like what you have, right?
I also think that when you're working on a project and you're looking at the colors,
you get tired of looking at it.
Or they're just glaring out at you, and it's almost like the flashing neon light. Like, you know, they're probably not bright.
Well,
but you've just been looking at them, and it's just too
right.
intense.
The colors I like, I picked. I really like those colors.
They're palette.
Colors that I really do like. But I don't know. I guess sometimes you just put them together. Maybe I was thinking then I should have changed my base color. Remember, I was going to do oatmeal, then I made a gray. Maybe
you
I should have done the oatmeal.
The oatmeal.
We
you
thought the gray
the
would be more wearable. Right, so I don't know. We'll have to listen. It's going to be lovely, whatever it is.
It is
going to be lovely.
It's going to be beautiful.
Right. So,
So,
are you finishing up your last minute projects, or are you knitting feverishly for Christmas? Trying to, or holidays, doesn't have to be Christmas, whatever it is.
Definitely didn't leave ourselves enough time for the holiday knitting.
Never did.
We get into the same problem every year. But next year will be better.
Next year will be better. I know, I keep listening to people January. And they say that. Well, I'll always be knitting at the holidays, even though I say that I'm not going to do it. There'll always be something that I'm knitting.
Well, it's just, I don't know what I was going to say. I was actually just going to say that this is our way of just saying goodbye.
Yeah, we wanted to say thank you to everybody who's watched the videos, who's messaged us, who's joined our Ravelry group.
Yes.
And it's always nice to be in the company of fellow crafters, people who have the same passion that we do for knitting, crocheting, whatever it might be. And we're looking forward to a really
strong 2018.
How are we starting? Creative. How are we starting 2018, Diana?
What do you mean?
Vogue.
Well, January 12th. For it's those of you who are going to be in Manhattan for Vogue Knitting Live,
yes,
we will have our traditional booth where we've been for the past several years. It's right by the stage, and it's a lot That's of fun. Right. So That's please right. stop by and introduce yourselves and come visit us. We look forward to meeting you. We are hoping to have some exciting new kits and different things that you haven't seen before. What else are we starting with? Well, we know Andrea Mowry is starting her Comfort Fade knit along.
Yep.
So that's starting at the beginning at the top of the year.
Mm-hmm.
So you can come in and pick out some yarn with that, for that project rather. What else do we have? There's a bunch of new things. Yeah,
a lot of new things.
Yes. So we'll have to wait and let some of it be a surprise, I suppose.
But exactly.
We're wishing all of you a beautiful, beautiful holiday. May you stay safe. We are so grateful to all of you. Mm-hmm. For those of you who have stopped in, and I just have to say that I'm floored with the gratitude for the gifts that we got this year. There was right. so much, which right. was really very sweet right. and gracious and just very touching. I did want to say one other thing, and it just slipped my mind.
About what? No, well, I've got plenty of things to say. But listen, we also want to wish you a happy new year. You know, hopefully 2018 will be better than 2017, if that's possible for some people.
Yes.
Right. And for sure. Especially as it is in regard to our knitting and our projects.
Well, I remembered what I wanted to say.
What's that?
We got a beautiful, beautiful delivery, Diana, who brought in all those caps.
Oh,
we
yeah.
were so touched.
She put the picture in.
I will put in a picture. Yeah. Four cellophane bags, huge bag full of these beautiful hats, knit just in time for Christmas.
Correct,
and they were picked up, and I know that they're going to make many children happy. So for all of those loving hands that participated in putting those hats together and creating such beautiful, beautiful caps, you really touched our hearts,
especially for little babies and children that need them.
So thank you. It's a beautiful community.
Whoever you knitters were, thank
knitters,
you so
crocheters,
much.
Crocheters, there were so many. Mm-hmm. And for those of you who continue to make them throughout the year, we want to say special thanks to you as well. And with that, happy, healthy, sweet new year.
Yes.
And until next year.
See you next year.
Bye.
Bye.